Oh, here's a pale elf. Oh. And a crag ogre and a pale elf and a pale elf and lots of pale elves and Vamrel. Greetings. A group of elves stands in a scattered ring around an ogre, but they do not appear to be engaged in battle. The ogre is bound with rope, and one of the elves tugs harshly on the line tied around the ogre's neck. Vamrel yells, "This is pointless, beast! You won't get anywhere being stubborn." The ogre only snorts angrily and pulls back on the rope. Two other elves prod him somewhat timidly with their pole axes. The ogre does not budge. One of the pale elves says, "Hey, Vamrel." One of the elves has turned to look at you, motioning at the man occupied with the ogre. The elves turn to look at you, hands falling to their weapons. Vamrel gives a final sharp yank on the rope before he turns as well. A rather sad specimen for an ogre. He came cheap. We need the muscle. Gods know they're good for little else. Vamrel gives the rope another tug. The ogre's already impressive scowl deepens. Kanna says, "The ogres of the Endless Pass were hardly stock. Perhaps their craggy cousins are more delicate." The ogre gives a great bellow and suddenly lunges backward, tearing the rope free of his captor's hands. With a triumphant roar, the ogre pulls apart the bindings on his arms. Oops! Vamrel glares at you. "Look what you've done!" "Oh dear," Kanna says. "I think that worked a little too well." "Stop that ogre," Vamrel says, "but don't damage my property. And bring me that fool's head." Are any of them going to attack us? Oh, they're attacking us. Well, the ogre's not attacking us. So I say attack the frickin' pale elves. Pale Elf Assassin's got plenty of fight in him. Tiny heal for us.
Hey.
Oh, can't knock him down? There we go. Oh, he just killed that ogre. Yeah, out of tricks, let's just kill him. Was he dead? Hey. Oh, he is dead. Well, all dead. Not exactly what we wanted, but... Find pole axe. Oh, bitter cut. Unique saber. 13-19 slash code versus deflection. Grants infestation of maggots, 1 per rest, and vile thorns, 2 per rest. Foe AoE, 10 damage by percentage of endurance lost over 20 seconds versus fortitude. And vile thorns. Area of effect, 26 to 38 versus deflection, sickened for 10 seconds. This saber it's also got minus 10 defense against poison. Meaning you are more likely to be poisoned? This saber belonged to the first mate of the Hangman's Bounty, a notorious pirate ship that roamed the Deadfire Archipelago 3 centuries ago. Legend has it that the crew seized a slave galley and, after killing the masters, decided to kill the slaves at the next port. One of the slaves, an elderly man with a scarred face and beady black eyes, came forward and demanded that he and his fellows be set free. The pirates laughed and refused him, but the old slave persisted. He warned them of the terrible plagues and punishments awaiting them, yet still they refused. When he raised his voice in anger, the first mate drew her saber and ran him through. Putrid green bile poured from the wound, running upward along the sword while the sailors watched in horror. The corruption spread from the dying man's chest to the first mate's saber and arm, filling her veins with venom and her flesh with squirming maggots. Ugh. The rest of the crew drove the ship aground and fled, leaving the slaves to flee and the first mate to rot next to her tainted blade. Yeah, I haven't seen any cursed weapons yet in this game, but if there would be one, I would think it's this one. None of us are using sabers, so I'm just gonna not use that anyway. Fine grade weapons and armor. Wow, that was sad. Everyone died.
Eyes open.
Just continue marking this out. We're gonna make it in 2 episodes because I don't want to stop here at 41
sure.
minutes. It's kind of longish. Oh, there's something here we can look at. Huh, with a question mark. You spy a tuft of fur caught on the shrub. You recognize the scent of the wolf. I found a tuft of wolf hair snagged on a bramble just east of the frozen lake. The wolf must have come through the area recently. Awesome, we're like detectives or something. Head to this, whatever this is, a rock. Yeah, that's where we kill those things. I love that, seeing that smooth out. Yeah, we'll head this way. Really liking the expansion so far. They've improved some things. Oh, here's something else. The teeth marks upon the deer bone suggest a large predator. I found a half-eaten deer carcass out in the wilderness just south of the frozen lake. It looks like the work of a large predator, and I found nearby prints leading away to the north. Hello? Slave tracker? And...
Don't see many on these roads. And the few we do are hunters, woodcutters, or smugglers.
Scared the crap out of me. She cocks an eyebrow at you and gives you a half smile. She holds herself with confident grace, a conspicuous holster slung over one hip, so yeah, it's Defala. Behind her is a wagon loaded with supplies. Manacles dangle from one end. Well, I'm not going to tip my hand. Which are you? Hunter, woodcutter, or smuggler? The high, clear peals of her laughter ring across the snowy plain.
I suppose you could say I'm a hunter.
Her fingers drum the tooled leather of her holster. Yeah, hint, hint.
I'm looking for a fugitive from Raid Saris, an indentured servant, and a wanted criminal.
The smile disappears from her face like a candle flame snuffed out by the wind. She watches you through humorless eyes. What exactly is he wanted for?
Besides breaking his indenture? He slew his master's 13-year-old son. Killed the boy before he fled.
Okay. So, fight, we're evil. Let's go with 5. He belongs in prison, not in a slaver's pen.
His master sees it differently.
She unholsters her pistol.
Shame we couldn't do business.
Well, that's that then. Combat. There we go. I hope we'll be okay with this. I mean... Cat is a little messed up. Probably won't be able to focus on one. I'll try, though. Nice. This guy's almost dead, right? Oh no, he's got fight in him. How's Mind Wave work again? Oh, it's been so long. Okay. So I pick my target and it comes out from them. Once he moves forward, it might hit those others. Hope it doesn't hit friends. Definitely camping after this, guys. Alright, he's dead. No, that's a dare, no. I thought I heard her selected for some reason. Defala.
Hey.
Knock her down. Oh, she's dead. Aren't you gonna lose morale? Your leader's dead. You really should flee. But no! Slave Hunter's dead. Ailef will be glad to hear of it. And then he'll leave the inn and, what's his name? Hafferick will be pleased. Fine Archibus.
Sure.
Fine weapons and armor and some silver. What's up, boy? Is he? Oh, what? I'm not ready for this. I'm gonna sleep first. I just wanted that mushroom thing. As you walk toward the frozen pool, a figure appears through the mist. Kneeling down next to a hole in the ice, the figure picks up a large chest and throws it into the water without hesitation. The figure looks around. You glimpse a face you've seen before. Kekseddel, one of Lafta's acolytes, pulls a hood over his head and throws a leather bag over his shoulder. Without looking back, he walks away in the direction of Stalwart Village. And doesn't see us. Upon arriving at the pond in the Russetwood, I spotted Kekseddel, a acolyte of Ondra's temple, hurriedly dropping a large object into the waters. It's a chest. So if this is a spot where offerings are cast away, Okrin's heirloom should lie at the bottom. Oh boy, we're gonna go catch hypothermia. A fine pistol, fine padded armor, and silver finning. That's it. So you don't have any special items. There's another thingy. Tin hat. Camp. Security reports that Drakes will attack the stronghold in 3 days. That's not good. Auto resolve. And we're nowhere near. Well, I guess we'll check out where he put this chest.
I'll see what I can find.
The horse is seeing us. I'm like, we're all red. We're doomed. You've been spotted. Ring!
You should test that ice with something heavy. Make sure it's safe. Maybe with an overweight priest that can't shut up.
Awesome.
What?
Is it safe? I actually took his suggestion. Well, the other guy was out here. Yeah. Cloudy water is visible through a thick hole cut through the thick ice. It is larger than a fishing hole, wider than a broadset amawa. Stirred, the surface of the water laps against the layered ice. You reach out to test the water. It nips at your fingers with every ripple, quickly numbing your hand after a few seconds. Inspect the area. You carefully inspect your surroundings. Animal tracks are plentiful, but what appear to be the footprints of Kith are also present near the hole. Looking closer into the hole, you notice a jagged ring of frost adhering to its walls. It has been rebroken, perhaps more than once. Look through the water to the bottom of the pond. The waters swirl, silty and nearly opaque. You attempt to see through the murk, but can make out nothing in particular. Dive in and search the bottom of the pond. Here we go. Roll for hypothermia. Who will dive in? Good idea. Cast Bulwark against the elements before diving in. Who will cast Bulwark against the elements? Ailef, can he cast it on someone other than himself? Does he have to be the one going in? Okay, on me, okay. Ailef begins to draw energy out of the ether and into a grimoire. There's a sudden flash of light from the open page, and you are bathed in a protective aura. You dip your hand into the water. You can feel its ripples climbing up your skin, but you notice no change in temperature, as if the water itself had become lukewarm. The cold, it seems, is no longer a threat. Who will dive in? Consider your options? I mean, it was cast on me, so I should dive in. Considering how to best deal with the situation, you step back and look at the hole on the frozen pond. Okay, well, we're diving in then. You dive into the water. The turbulent darkness engulfs you, but its embrace feels almost warm and welcoming. Occasionally, a cold shiver runs through your limbs, but the protection offered by the spell lets you swim with ease to the bottom of the pond. Directly below the hole, at the very bottom, your hands find heavy objects made of wood and metal. They are chests, small but heavy. You start to bring them up to the surface one by one, struggling to carry their weight through the water. After a heroic effort, you come out of the frozen pond. You let a few minutes pass to recover from your ordeal, and then you're ready to inspect your findings. The chests are marked with the symbols of Ondra. You grab one of them and pry its lid open to reveal its contents. Inside, all you see are rocks. Were they trying to fool the very goddess Ondra herself? Or did they want to be seen throwing that in? Figured no one would dive in and grab it. So they're keeping the stuff for themselves, obviously. You shake the surprise off and grab another chest. The same results greet you after opening it. More rocks and nothing of value. Something is assuredly amiss. As proof of your findings, you take one of the empty chests with you. Back here. I recovered several empty chests that bear Andra's symbol. The medallion I seek wasn't inside any of them. They were filled only with rocks. It looks like Lafta, the priestess of Ondra, has much to answer for. Chest of rocks, huh? Empty gift-bearer chest. Expecting to find Okrin's medallion from the depths of the icy waters of the Russetwood, you instead recovered chests filled only with rocks. As proof, you took this empty chest with you. Very interesting, very interesting. Anyway, I got this stuff to clear out here.
Margarine's fire casts light in dark places.
And icy places. There you go. Uh-oh. Who dat? Oh. This is where you've been, duh. Sorry, guys. More dead people laying around. It's a conspiracy. Finger berries. Oh. These stones are strangely warm to the touch. Though most of the rooms are indecipherable, a few look like names. Hmm. You mean backer messages we can't read? Hurrah! Can we go through these trees? Apparently not. There must be thick overgrowth here. Overgrowth. Just in case, guys. I know that wolf is around here somewhere. It's gotta be a big deal for them to be leaving all these hints. Oh, there's another men progress thingy. Canna. I gotta check on him. He doesn't like to do what he's told.
Following your lead.
More winter wolves. Hi. I hope we can get through here. Chain lightning. Oh, it's already knocked. Let me hit that one then. Blood. That was easy. Probably quickest battle yet so far. They get damaged though. Durant's messed up.
Keeping an eye out.
Got it.
There's blood here. Skeleton. Lots of skeletons. Can't look at them, huh? This goes to Wolf Cave. Oh, the wolf's in there, I bet. What gave that away? Just check out this little area. I don't think I can get there. Never mind. I think I've been there. It's a big map. More dead people. Told you it was a conspiracy. Oh. Greyjaw. Alright, before we mess with the bodies, let's attack Greyjaw.
Following your lead.
Apparently there's a huge bear as well as a huge wolf here.
This thing isn't good.
Sounds like he starts saying ladies and gents. All the usuals. Usual suspects.
Doing the job.
Ooh, knock Pelagina right down. Have him make himself useful, Blessing. Okay. A corpse. Fine dagger, arquebus lockpick, some hides. Bet the better of these hunters, huh? Pushing a fleet feet. Ooh, a coil of resourcefulness. Camping supply. Plus 15 trap accuracy. Plus 1 weapon change recovery and plus 1 dexterity. This simple belt isn't much to look at, but it's been a favorite of savvy adventurers for years. Its snug but comfortable fit, and its myriad pouches, stealth, and loops allow the wearers quick access to weapons and tools. Armorers and leather workers have tried over the years to replicate the coil of resourcefulness, or even to improve it, but the ideal design remains a matter of controversy. All anyone can agree on is that none of the recently produced belts are as good as the original. Every few years, however, an adventurer will show up at an inn, campfire, or hunting lodge, claiming to wear the original coil of resourcefulness. Speculation will run rampant once again as supporters and detractors compare the most recent specimen to the various and contradictory accounts from old adventurers' journals. Actually, pretty interesting. Weapon change recovery, though? I don't change weapons that often. I mean, isn't it, like, instantaneous? When we switch from range to melee? I thought it was. It looks like it is. So, I'm not gonna keep this. Where's this bear?
Time to see. Not be seen.
I don't think what if it was a werebear, but I know there were three bodies here already. Interesting. Okay, so stay tuned for next episode when perhaps we finish exploring the Russetwood. Maybe we'll even go into this wolf cave, who knows. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. and enduring, grow strong.